1939, it was divided into three. One part of Poland was given to the Third Reich, to Germany. All Poles were deported from there, and German people were supposed to sit there. It was a territory aimed to enlarge Germany. Germany wants big country. That's the west part. The eastern part that is marked here with this stripes was given to Russia. That was this Ribbentrop-Molotov agreement that actually set quiet with Russia. That was a kind of guarantee for Hitler that Russia won't interfere his plans. How it was ended, you know? How this quiet ended? It was ended in 1941 when Hitler was so, sorry, ego freak that he invaded Russia. It was called Barbarossa operation when Hitler invaded Russia. The genocide of the Jewish people started by the invasion of Russia, and we'll talk about it in a minute. In the center, between the east that went to Russia and the west that went to the Great Reich, to Germany, was the Generalgouvernement. That was the SS country, and it was the lowest and the worst of it all, because that was the chaos. That was where everything was allowed. Everything could be done there. That was the Generalgouvernement. The capital of the Generalgouvernement was Krakow. Krakow was established as the capital of the Generalgouvernement. Hans Frank was sitting in Krakow. The Jewish community in Krakow before the war had 60,000 Jews. But you can't even imagine that the capital of the Generalgouvernement will have any Jews. Who wants Jews in the capital of the Generalgouvernement? And that's why a lot of deportation was done from Krakow since the beginning. Since the beginning of the Krakow was occupied on the 6th of September, 6 days after the war started, Krakow was occupied and deportation of Jews started because the Generalgouvernement didn't want any Jews in the capital of the Generalgouvernement. Ghetto Krakow, that will go there a bit later, was established with only 15,000 Jews. 15,000 Jews means that all the rest were deported even before the establishment of the ghetto. And now I want to open a sograin, you know, to say something, what is a ghetto, because I was talking with the kids. A ghetto is when you take a small part and poor part of the city, you close it with a wall, and you tell all the Jews of the city to live only there.